The most striking finding that we found is that 93% of cyber leaders and 86% of cyber business leaders believe that the geopolitical instability makes a catastrophic cyber event likely in the next 2 years.
In the U.S., a new bulletin tonight amid this Israeli war. Tonight, there is new concern that Iranian-backed hackers might have targeted the water supply system near Pittsburgh.
Alexa, reheat pasta.
Reheating pasta.
It's cool, right?
Yeah, I didn't know you guys put Alexa in a microwave.
Yeah, we're putting her in a lot of stuff now. But trust me, there are a lot of fails.
Like what?
The incident.
Wait, that was you guys.
I don't know, was it?
Powering up, powering down.
She says she's doing it, but I don't see anything.
Do you? Holy.
Why am I here?
Yes.
Because it's my military duty. Only 0.5% of the population survived. For every one survivor, there are 1,000 dead.
For centuries, you believed in someone you'd never seen. Millions just like me will be here soon. They will all want the same thing. You'll do what you were created for.
As we all know, something happened 24 days ago. And all contact was lost with most of the world. Everything outside of this circle is in complete darkness as of now.
We'll make anyone still alive in the quarantine zone attack us. There are 160 million of them.
People?
Not really.
Contact with command is lost, and we're everybody's last hope.
Do you think they're going to take Moscow?
The war has begun.
Sonic, a little ball of super energy in an extremely handsome package. On my planet, people were always after my powers. So I came to yours. It gets a little lonely, but that's okay. I am living my best life on Earth. Wow! Ow! At the plate, Sonic! At the pitcher's mound, also Sonic!
Ugh, I can't with that guy.
Uh-oh.
We're about to go into a dark winter. A dark winter to fight this pandemic. We're still facing a very dark winter.
A significant cyber attack taking place across the nation and around the world. Federal agencies, state governments, and major universities have been hit with a campaign of data theft and ransomware. CBS News has confirmed that the Cybersecurity and Infrastructure Security Agency is providing support to agencies that have been targeted. Johns Hopkins University and its health system says the data breach may have impacted sensitive personal and financial information, including contact information and health billing records. Now, there's no confirmation about what group or country is behind the intrusions, but U.S. intelligence believes a criminal organization operating inside Russia is responsible.
Tonight, senior government officials are racing to limit the impact
of what one cyber expert is calling potentially the largest theft and extortion event in recent history. American targets include multiple federal agencies, including the Department of Energy, plus Johns Hopkins-affiliated hospitals in Maryland and Florida, Georgia's statewide university system, and the Minnesota Department of Education. British Airways was also hit. Officials say the hackers are part of a cyber criminal gang called Klopp, believed to operate from inside Russia.
Good evening. I'm speaking to you from GCHQ, the government's communications headquarters. This is because what I have to tell you is of extreme importance. Our nation is under threat of imminent cyber attack. We have reason to believe this attack by an as yet unidentified foreign power will be far more damaging and wide-ranging than anything we have seen before. We must all immediately prepare ourselves for the impact of this invisible strike. I'll hand over now to Daniel Patrick from the cyber defense team here at GCHQ.
Thank you, Prime Minister. In a cyber attack, everything connected to the internet can be turned against us. So whilst this attack will not immediately harm us physically, it could dismantle our very way of life. Our critical infrastructure is vulnerable. Basic energy supplies, water reserves, transport systems, and in particular our communications, the internet, mobile phone networks, and TV broadcasts may be targeted. Our defenses are strong, but we must expect a significant impact on how we live imminently.
Your safety is this government's absolute priority. Our cyber task force is on standby and ready to counter this attack, but there is no doubt that the hours, days, and weeks ahead will be challenging. Please do not panic buy food. Rations will be allocated if necessary. Above all, remain calm.
Een van de reactoren van de kerncentrale van Westerdonk die zijn in één keer uitgevallen.
De kerncentrale?
Het is geen ballen. De kerncentrale is gesaboteerd van binnenuit.
Ik hoop dan ook dat we deze zaak achter ons kunnen laten. Hoe zorgen we ervoor dat we er als samenleving op vooruit gaan?
Het zijn natuurlijk mooie woorden, mevrouw de premier, maar daar kopen we niets mee.
Weet je er al van?
Niemand. Geen politie, hebben ze gezegd.
Daarom zit jij hier. Wie denkt dat we je kunnen vertrouwen? Dat komt uit dat je dat filmpje net achtergehouden of dat je die pannen wil trekken.
Doe jij waar je goed in bent, dan doe ik wat ik moet doen.
We hebben net vernomen dat er nucleair materiaal gestolen zat op de kerncentrale.
En wat zijn ze van plan met dat spul? Een vuile bom?
Omdat zo'n bom een hele stadswijk of een stadsdeel nucleair kan verontreinigen.
Imagine that we say, well, you know, we need to take down the internet for a while, and it is dangerous, you know, to go on the internet uncontrolled because, look, we are prone to cyber attacks. Everybody now needs a digital identity to log onto the internet safely. You know, you have the perfect pretext to take control again over people's liberties and to monitor ordinary citizens and make their, you know, freedom of movement even online limited to whether or not they comply with the government.
Pay insufficient attention to the frightening scenario of a comprehensive cyber attack, which would bring to a complete halt to the power supply, transportation, hospital services, our society as a whole. The COVID-19 crisis would be seen in this respect as a small disturbance in comparison to a major cyber attack.
So sorry to bother you. You must be Amanda.
Why did you come here?
In my line of work, you have to understand the patterns that govern the world. Can help you see the future. And I knew something was coming.
understand. What do you mean?
We are seeing ongoing cyber attacks across the country.
The truth is much scarier.
What is the truth?
We're gonna be okay, right?
Aren't you the one who always said, if you're not paranoid by now, it's too late?
Haven't you been picking up on what's going on out there? We've all been deserted. There is no going back to normal.
A lack of cybersecurity has become a clear and immediate danger to our society worldwide. We have seen in the past few months, for example, ransomware attacks targeting hospitals, critical infrastructure, school systems, the power grid, and many other essential services. Citizens are feeling the repercussions of cyber attacks directly. Citizens are impacted by energy shortages, delayed medical treatment, and other effects this new breed of audacious cyber attacks causes. This is not a problem that is easily solved. Ransomware attacks are complex, and criminal enterprises are increasing their scale and impact. This highlights the need for a structured multi-stakeholder, multilateral approach to secure our society against some. In this, we must all work together. Governments are in charge of guaranteeing security, but the deep expertise that is needed to develop a secure cyber ecosystem often lies with the private sector. Similarly, just as governments are often pooling the resources which each other through international organizations such as Interpol to fight physical crime, we need more similar collaboration between governments and, I should add, private business to fight cybercrime. The good news is that such public-private collaboration efforts already exist, as we demonstrate today. Recognizing the need to mobilize a global response to the growing cyber threats, the World Economic Forum launched the Center for Cybersecurity, as I mentioned, in 2018. Our center provides an independent and impartial platform to foster collaboration between all members of the global cybersecurity community, both in the public and in the private sectors.
Imagine a digital single payment solution that could be used for any kind of payment throughout the euro area. Guess what? It could become a reality. A digital euro. Easy, safe, fast, reliable. Digital money from the European Central Bank at your fingertips whenever you need it. But how would it work? Say you've gone for a meal with a friend and you want to split the bill. Simple. Open the digital euro wallet on your smartphone, check your balance, enter the amount to pay your friend, confirm your transfer. Your friend will receive the money instantly, free of charge. It doesn't matter which country you're in or who your payment provider is. Payments are still made instantly, even offline. It's also easy to use the digital euro at your favorite local shops. Unlock your device, place it on the terminal, authenticate, make the payment online or offline. If you want, you can also use a physical card. What about e-commerce? The digital euro is also available when you're buying something online. Be it digital or physical, a euro will always be a euro and have the same value irrespective of format. Let's embrace the digital era with the digital euro.
To go into a dark winter to fight this pandemic. We're still facing a very dark winter.
Is the pandemic over?
The pandemic is over. We still have a problem with COVID. We're still doing a lot of work on it. But the pandemic is over.
What else are we not listening to that we need to take action on now?
Well, the idea of a Cyberattack attack is kind of the nightmare scenario because they're a pathogen with a high death rate would be picked. Now, the good news is most of the work we're going to do to be ready for pandemic two, I call this pandemic one.
From Congress.
Well, we'll get through at least this year. We do need more money, but we don't just need more money for vaccines for children eventually. We need more money to plan for the second pandemic. There's going to be another pandemic. We have to think ahead.
Well, could the next pandemic make the height of the COVID-19 outbreak look mild? That's what some experts are predicting for what's being called Disease X.
Dr. Hotez says Disease X, the next pandemic, could hit hard whenever it arrives.
We cannot kick this can down the road. If we do not make the changes that must be made, then who will? And if we do not make them now, and when? When the next pandemic comes knocking, and it will, we must be ready to answer decisively, collectively, and equitably. And for enhanced international cooperation, the pandemic accord, a generational commitment that we will not go back to the old cycle of panic and neglect that left our world vulnerable, but move forward with a shared commitment to meet shared threats with a shared response. That's why we say the pandemic accord is a generational agreement. A commitment from this generation is important because it's this generation that experiences how awful a small virus could be.
Good morning, Miss Garcia.
Good morning, sunshine. I miss you. I could kiss you right now.
Someday.
Curfew is now in effect. All unauthorized citizens must stay indoors.
Tensions rise as we enter the 213th week of lockdown.
A grim new reality emerges.
COVID-23 has mutated.
Beginning thermal scan. Thermal scan normal.
A horrifying new development
new
today.
New data confirms the virus attacks the brain tissue.
I'm immune!
Worldwide death toll rises to over 110 million.
All infected Americans are being forced into quarantine camps.
Sarah, what's going on?
Department of Sanitation.
Sarah, talk to me.
I think my neighbor has a fever.
It'll be so much easier if you just open the door. Mrs. Grant, you have visitors.
Sarah, please. Sarah, open that door.
Sarah, do not open that door.
No! Please!
Guards will be arriving in 4 to 6 hours. You must not attempt to leave your home, or you will be shot on sight.
This is my message to you.
I know you're in there.
They're coming.
You have to
to let you go.
No.
Sarah!
Say goodbye to me.
Healthcare professionals across the world are gearing up for a new potential pandemic, a pandemic which they say will be known as Disease X. No, this disease has nothing to do with Twitter's new name, neither is it a social media plague. Disease X is a legitimate health scare, the next unknown disease of epidemic potential. This term was formalized by the WHO in 2018. It was named X because of the lack of knowledge about it. It's not known what this disease will be, whether it will jump from animals to humans, or whether it will be a mysterious lab creation. But one thing scientists are certain about is this. Disease X is coming. They don't know when, they don't know how. What they do know is that it could be far worse than the Wuhan virus, that it could cause more deaths than the Wuhan virus. He said, the planet should be ready for a disease deadlier than COVID. That a doomsday COVID variant with the power to send the world back to square one is still a big possibility.
The British government has unveiled a new vaccine research facility where scientists are working to prevent future pandemics. It's located at Porton Down, a high-security research facility best known for its work on chemical warfare. Experts are preparing for what is known as Disease X, or the next pandemic virus.
All of this is tied into the pandemic treaty. They are using a disease that is not yet discovered as the reason for signing over national sovereignty. In fact, every single nation has signed on to preliminary agreements with the WHO, handing all directives related to pandemic responses over to them. And they have already taken it upon themselves to use this future quote-unquote hypothetical pandemic as a reason to demand nations sign on to the finalized agreement.
And then the other key in order to have better prepared and to address the disease X is the pandemic agreement. The pandemic agreement can bring all the experience, all the challenges that we have faced, and all the solutions into one. And that agreement can help us to prepare for the future in a better way, because this is about a common enemy. And without a shared response, starting from the preparedness, we will face the same problem as COVID. And deadline for the pandemic agreement is May 2024, and member states are negotiating. This is between countries, and I hope they will deliver this pandemic agreement by that time, on the deadline, because if this generation cannot do it, we're the lived community, we have the first-hand experience, I don't think incoming generation, the next generation will do it. So for our children and grandchildren's sake, I think we have to convert all the lessons we have learned into this pandemic and prepare the world for the future.
Donald Trump, Barack Obama, and former Speaker of the House Nancy Pelosi are just a few of the high-profile politicians who went viral for appearing to say or do things that never actually happened.
Fake videos, fake audio clips that look real, convincingly real.
They're called deep fakes. Robert Weissman is with the progressive think tank Public Citizen. And as another presidential campaign ramps up, he warns the artificial intelligence tool may threaten democracy.
The technology is at a high enough quality that we're going to see political deep fakes that will fool people, that may fool everyone, and that could turn an election.
Hampshire Attorney General's office is investigating reports of an apparent robocall that used artificial intelligence to mimic President Biden's voice in an effort to urge voters to skip Tuesday's Democratic primary.
An international alliance of multiple countries has been pushing to dethrone the dollar, and now they've added more key members. Dale Hurd brings us this look at their mission to transform how the world does business.
These countries comprise almost half of the world's population, hold close to half the world's oil, and want to dethrone the dollar as the world's reserve currency, known as BRICS. This collection of emerging economies, whose name is an acronym for members Brazil, Russia, India, China, and South Africa, doubled in size on January 1st, adding Egypt, Ethiopia, Iran, Saudi Arabia, and the United Arab Emirates. More than 30 other nations have expressed interest in joining this group that wants to ditch the dollar and establish a new global economic order.
The largest assistance package yet from the U.S. to aid Ukraine in its war with Russia. The
The $3 billion in direct aid to Ukraine includes 50 Bradley fighting vehicles. It's the first time the armored carrier will be sent to Ukraine. The package also includes nearly 300 other armored vehicles, as well as air defense systems and anti-tank rockets.
Moments ago, from Capitol Hill, House Republicans, with help from some Democrats, approving more than $14 billion in aid for Israel only.
The U.S. is delivering its first military aid package to Taiwan in an effort to deter any possible future aggression from China. Officials say the $345 million package includes training and weapons from U.S. stockpiles. It also comes as America gives military assistance to Ukraine. Officials estimate the U.S. has given at least $44 billion in security assistance to Ukraine since January of 2021.
Tensions in the Red Sea are escalating. Yemen's Houthi rebels say 10 of their fighters died in a skirmish with the U.S. Navy. The U.S. says it fired in self-defense. U.S. ships have repeatedly shot down Houthi drones and missiles fired at commercial ships. But this was the first time the U.S. Navy has said that its personnel killed Houthi militants. In the past 6 weeks, there have been 23 incidents.
The U.S. retaliation now coming after the deadly drone attack on U.S. troops, killing three U.S. soldiers in Jordan. The Pentagon giving President Biden multiple options. Tonight, the president says he has now decided how the U.S. will respond. The president tonight saying he holds Iran responsible for supplying the weapons used in the attack. The Pentagon says U.S. forces in the region have come under attack at least 165 times by Iranian-backed militants. This one, of course, taking American lives.
A drone attack struck an American military outpost in Jordan near the border with Syria yesterday. Three American soldiers were killed. Nearly three dozen others were injured. President Biden says an Iran-backed militia is to blame here. And he said, quote, we shall respond.
I think it's just a superstition.
Welcome! Listening to the wind of change.
Wow. I mean, I've seen pictures, but this is...
We don't talk politics. Here we are. One.
Hey, guys.
Wait a minute, what is going on down there?
Oh, whoa.
We gotta get out now, guys.
Let's get out.
Oh, my God.
Houston, do you read?
War has broken out below. And we were told to take the ISS by any means necessary.
If we got orders from our government to take control.
What do you suggest we do now?
The Russians got the same orders as us. And they just struck first.
Struck first.
Truly, we're evolved species.
Attention, attention. Dear comrades, the People's City Council informs you that due to an incident at the Chernobyl nuclear power plant, there is an adverse radioactive situation in the city of Pripyat.
The reactor is in a subcritical state. As you all know, if enough fuel burns through and gets to the water, there will be a steam explosion full of radioactive material.
The contamination, if uncontained, will spread to Kiev, Moscow, and all of Western Europe.
Right, so we have to get the water out.
The volunteers will receive payment.
We're talking dirty water in a confined space, not a clean swimming pool. All your engineers just won't cut it.
I'm going back down.
You won't survive again.
We have no authority to order it.
Do you really want to risk the citizens of Kiev getting ready for the May Day celebration?
Breathe. In and out.
Pennsylvania is on edge tonight.
There was a mindset throughout the industry.
Highways are backed up and telephones are jammed.
A major accident could never happen.
Critical questions remain to be answered.
And I believe that. But I was wrong.
It was the first step in a nuclear nightmare, a breakdown in an atomic power plant.
I heard a really loud noise coming from the plant.
Temperatures were soaring inside the reactor.
Radioactivity was getting into the control room.
They wanted to keep information from the general public.
It's a lot worse than what they're telling us.
They gotta cover up something.
Do you see any need to start to evacuate people out of that area?
No, we do not.
There were indications that the accident was a massive cover-up.
They're either lying to us or they don't know what they're doing.
Certain days you could taste a metallic taste in your mouth.
We're talking about contamination of thousands of square miles of land.
The main driver here is still making money.
They would take every shortcut they possibly could.
Whistleblowers who come out of the nuclear industry, we always know that they are in danger.
They would stop at nothing to silence him.
You don't threaten my family, I will kill for them.
Most people think the company didn't know what was going on. Nothing could be further from the truth.
The world needs to know what happened at Three Mile Island.
I know that I've lived a relatively comfortable life.
Stop! Lucy!
You need to go home. Vault dwellers are an endangered species. I do not think you would be willing to do what it takes to survive up here. If you insist on staying, then you will have to adapt.
Sing last night, he would have said no, so I didn't. I'm getting late. Okay, I gotta go.
Okay, call me when you get to the airport.
What was that?
Will, something's wrong.
Sam.
Will, what?
We have unconfirmed reports of a large seismic event off the California coast, with reports of power outages across the United States.
She come back.
I didn't know where else to go.
Have you talked to Sam?
We got disconnected.
What's the last thing she said?
She sounded scared.
Let's look at what we know, Will. We have no idea what's happening. Yet we got F-22s doing flybys. My only daughter, she's alone, 2,000 miles away. So I only have one question for you. Are you coming with me?
All communications are down. The government is silent. We don't know who or what is causing this.
There's a lot to be afraid of out there. There's a lot of real danger.
Should have told me that you had a gun.
I'm assuming that you've never fired a firearm.
I've seen war game simulations. Events just like this. They're designed to erase rational behavior with what appears to be a singular incident.
You ever seen clouds like that before?
Will, get back in the car!
I need you to promise you'll always keep us safe.
I promise.
You just drive, I got this.
Stay like this forever.
Do you really think that?
Terrorists have taken possession of nuclear missiles on a cargo ship off the coast. If these babies go off, it'll be World War III.
To choose this life over friends, over family.
It's time to get loud.
Let's fly, baby!
Come on, bring it! I'm gonna win big. Choose not a life of imitation. This did
constitute the reservation. Now that's what I'm talking about.
The annual purge will conclude in 3, 2, 1. Thank you for your participation.
We survived.
All police and emergency services have been reinstated. All crime, including murder, is now illegal.
Come on, let's get to work.
One night only. Rest of the year is peaceful.
Help me! Help me! The purge is over, please!
No, it ain't.
This is insane. Nobody hear the sirens?
There's no crime anymore. Anything goes.
You rich can't hide behind your steel walls no more. Powerless. How's that feel? It's the real purge. The forever purge!
Hurry up! They're coming! Come on! Follow me!
There's nowhere safe to go. No way to get help.
Oh my God.
We gotta find another way to get out of here.
This country's gonna collapse.
Mexico is opening its borders for the next 6 hours.
Let's go.
We're in this together.
States Army ramps up activity.
The White House issued warnings to the Western forces as well as the Florida Alliance.
The three-term president assures the uprising will be dealt with swiftly.
Let me know if you want to try anything on.
Are you guys aware there's like a pretty huge civil war going on all across America?
We just try to stay out. With what we see on the news, seems like it's for the best.
Citizens of America,
the so-called Western forces of Texas and California
have suffered a very great defeat at the hands of the United States military.
Mr. President, do you regret the use of airstrikes against American citizens?
We're moving to D.C. today.
We need to go down there.
They shoot journalists on sight in the Capitol. Every instinct in me says this is death.
What if?
Every time I survived a war zone, I thought I was sending a warning home. Don't do this. But here we are.
There's some kind of misunderstanding here.
What?
Well, you're American, okay?
Okay. What kind of American are you? You don't know?
The Western forces will reach the White House on July 4th.
Oh my God.
Get in the car! Get in the car! Move, move, move!
You're gonna hang back.
I'm not hanging back.
One nation under God, indivisible, with liberty and justice for all.
Go, 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 go!
God bless America.
I'm telling you, it's going to be another hot one out there. In fact, there are heat alerts in effect for New Jersey, feeling like 100 degrees.
First time in New York history, people froze to death in the middle of July.
What is it?
The death chill. The power to kill by fear itself. Your veins turn to rivers of ice. Your bones crack. And the last thing you see is your own tear ducts freezing up.
This week, the U.S. government releasing a new report on unidentified anomalous phenomena, what most people know as UFOs. The report found that between August of last year and April this year, the office tracking these sightings received nearly 300 reports. Some of these incidents are still under investigation because they could pose a security threat to U.S. military operations, especially aviation.
Before first contact, we were fighting amongst ourselves. We needed the legislators to show us a better way.
They're protecting us from anarchy.
The state of our union is strong. Unemployment is the lowest in history. Poverty has been eradicated. Crime is non-existent. Let us give thanks.
My name is Karelin. I am the supervisor for Earth. Under our supervision, you will all flourish here. peace, health, security for everyone.
Why are you here?
We need a messenger between the overlords and Earth. What are you thinking?
I'm thinking I want to see who I'm talking to.
The overlords talk about peace, but this is an invasion.
Look at the good here. There is no war, no disease.
I would rather the world went down under our control and flourished under theirs.
They have never wanted what's best for us.
There's no need to be afraid.
They want to destroy us.
This is not about us. This is about the whole damn world.
Tell them the truth about what you really are.